hang. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost all the shine. I can buy a Bentley, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love, cause I be loving. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care, I crash a ghost. Got two cribs and two states, I be doing the most. I got white folks money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't. Big bang, tight, low, bang, bang. Big bang, tight, low.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 19 on EA Sports. On tap, we've got what should be a fairly intriguing matchup between the San Francisco 49ers and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
And we're about 5 miles northwest of downtown Tampa at beautiful Raymond James Stadium near Florida's Gulf Coast. Just a minute ago, it was Jameis Winston leading his Buccaneers out of the tunnel. They're on their feet here in Tampa as the Bucs get set to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at this Buccaneer ball club. They come in off the very rare tie a game ago.
And it'll be interesting to see what their mindset is going into this game. Sometimes that can be a deflator, and sometimes that can just really make you mad and more determined the next time out.
On the other side of the field for the visiting 49ers, it's been a great start to the season. Back-to-back wins to begin the campaign.
Yeah, you don't want to get too excited. There's still a lot of season to go, but they've come out playing good fundamental football, and that might carry them a long way.
This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They'll have Jimmy G calling the shots. Grew up in the northern suburbs of Chicago, went to Eastern Illinois. Jimmy Garoppolo.
It was fun getting ready for this game, wasn't it? Because normally we talk to the coaches and the players. I think you and I asked to talk to the trainer to see how his arm is going to be.
A lot of ice after last week.
After last week's game, boy, what a performance that was. And you know who else is having fun? Receivers. Because they get a chance to do what they do best, which is go out and catch the ball.
Yeah, and that last week effort, he threw for well over 400 yards. So first and 10 now from the 30. Garoppolo now, first down throw. Gets this one left side to Pettis. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, a 22.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult third and 8 coming up.
Gerald McCoy is always going to be linked with Ndamukong Suh. They came into the NFL in the same draft class. There was a lot of debate about who was going to be the better defensive tackle. They just do it two different ways. McCoy, more movement, more elusiveness. That allowed him to make the play there for a short gain.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. To throw is Garoppolo. And that is incomplete.
But there is a certainty in this game. We know that wherever he goes, he's going to draw a big-time crowd.
Throws into double coverage there. And look, that's something that he's going to have to deal with a lot in this game, I'm sure.
Yeah, they were lucky to get away with that one where it just fell incomplete. But they're going to count on him to uncover late in routes and make some difficult catches.
And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. So make some room next to Tom Dempsey on the NFL's all-time field goal distance leaderboard. That's going to go down officially as a 63-yarder.
Let's not forget about David Akers, Jason Elam, and Sebastian Janikowski, too. So now Matt Prater at 64 has got a little bit of company up near the top spot. That was one heck of a kick right there.
Now it's gold after splitting the uprights to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. They're led out by a man raised in Alabama, went to Florida State. It's their quarterback, Jameis Winston.
And when you scout him on tape, you see the big windup delivery. But one other thing I noticed, when it's time to turn it loose, to let that ball go, it gets out of his hands quickly at that point and gets from A to B, B being the receiver, with some dispatch.
Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Ready. Flag.
Now movement already. So a flag down here on our very first play. That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Still first down.
A full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Jameis to throw it. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. He was trying to find O.J. Howard, and it's second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down.
Ready.
From the shotgun, it's Winston. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They'll wind up getting 10 back there as it'll leave him with a third and and on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Ready. Blue, ready.
From the gun, Winston. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. The speedster Dante Pettis back deep to return. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Looking to throw. Garoppolo. Over the middle, he finds Pettis complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. Garoppolo to throw on second down. Going underneath, it's Coleman. And he's able to take this one up to the 30. Five-yard line.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
20. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Snap comes at one. Garoppolo drops it off for Coleman. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
But it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
They run with Breida, and that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I say the staff that's up in the booth watching the game, they may want to file that one away. See how fast the free safety closed to make that play? Might want to check into a throw the next time.
On second down, here's Garoppolo. He rifles one that's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. And now off to the races, down the right side. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Charles, I'm looking at you, and understandably, your mouth is wide open in disbelief. What were they thinking?
That's going to be one of the great mysteries, but I do know this. When they went out on offense, I will guarantee they told them, don't just make anticipatory throws. Make sure you see it before you throw it. Didn't happen here.
Trying to protect that lead, and now they gave it up. The point after through the raindrops, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 31-yard line. Now Garoppolo to try again after the pick six. Looking deep downfield. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
But I guess that answers the question whether or not they want him throwing it again right away after throwing the pick six on the previous drive.
Yeah, not something conservative or underneath. Pretty big shot right there.
Got him right back in the saddle and said, go ahead and sling it, big guy.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 as they line up second and 10. Second and 10. Wide open receiver complete. Touchdown, 49ers. Marquise Goodwin, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for six. That's an early touchdown grab for last week's NFC Offensive Player of the Week. He was so electric, and they talked about it all week long. Have to try to contain it.
And now for him, being able to focus on the task at hand and not just immediately assume that last week it totally carries over, but you got to like the start that he has, showing those great hands that we've seen from him throughout.
Gold with the extra point, and the lead is now 10-7. The long touchdown pass gets him six on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. Gold now out to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Winston and the Bucks take over now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Four down. Ready. Blue ready.
Now a carry here for Orleans Darkwa. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. One quarter down, 10-7 our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Bucks in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter, and they've got it here with a first down. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Four down, check. Ready.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Now Darquan. And he's got some space here. Still staying on his feet. Are you serious? And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, 3 plays, 3 first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38.
Ready, black, 22.
On 1st and 10, Winston. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. And now running right through it. That one goes for 36 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who could make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
Well, they've been practicing goal line offense all week. Let's see if they're able to capitalize here. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal. So stuff from the 2, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create, and if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucs may have moved.
False start, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5.
Still 2nd down.
Things made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on 2nd and goal. Here's Darquan, and he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. 2 straight shots on the ground, now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
3rd and goal, Winston. Escaping the pressure, and he will score! Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Jameis Winston, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Bucs are able to strike for 6. That was a case of practice making perfect. Goal line offense had been their focus while prepping for this one.
Almost as if you go back to training camp, isn't it? You strip it bare, you figure out what you need to make something work. Work on it all week long and get it done. That's got to feel great for them.
Extra point attempt to come here. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now 14-10. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Well, looking back to that 1st quarter, they struggled, but now here in 2, they seem to have some rhythm.
And it really shouldn't be a surprise to us, because when we were in the production meetings, we asked a few of the players about Hey, what if things get a little rocky early? They all said the exact same thing. We're prepared, so we're confident things will work out. And so far, they have started to do so.
Those three words we hear a lot, stay the course. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and 6.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Now a handoff looking right. Space to maneuver at the 40. And a cutback right side. Through an opening, and there he goes. Touchdown, 49ers. Jared. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slip through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 17-14. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Gold now out to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 23. They go play action. Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. On the run, Darquan. And some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That good for 19 and a first down. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you cross state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday in the National Football League. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. He got 29 yards that time.
When Mike Evans sees man coverage, I don't think he's the only guy who gets excited. I guarantee the guy throwing the ball does, because guess what? He's got a lot of options about where to place it because of Mike Evans' size and frame.
Ready, Mike 25.
From the red zone now, Winston. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Winston now. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7.
One thing that I liked about this guy during the draft process was his motor. Of course, I loved his skills, but he plays hard on every down.
And that motor on full display there as he gets his first NFL sack. Second and goal from the 6 this time.
Ready? Mike 25. Ready to go.
Working out of the gun, Winston. Buying time to his left. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Six plays got him down here. This is play number 7, third and goal.
Everyone's got four down. Ready.
To throw is Winston. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. DeForest Buckner in there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
And that's the kind of stand all defenses are seeking. Third and goal, backs against the wall, and they get a monster sack, and now they're going to force him into a field goal. For them, that's a win.
And now the Tampa Bay field goal unit comes out here. And his kick here is good. Tie things up as we head toward halftime. They had it first and goal, 3 attempts, couldn't get it in, so they settle for 3.
Yeah, the field tends to shrink a little bit the closer you get to the goal line, doesn't it? It doesn't sound right. It sounds a little counterintuitive. But you run out of space to run the deep routes, so they can just sit on the shorter stuff if you're going to throw it. If you want to run it, there's just not as much space. They end up having to take 3 there.
The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
let's
see if they dial it up this drive. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, 49ers. Marquise Goodwin with his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for 6.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Now Gold for the extra point. Gold with the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Gold now out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here? They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting 49ers on top. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks. And welcome in, everybody, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Time for a look around the NFL here in week 3 of the new year. We'll begin up at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. And it's the Rams who are out in front in that one. Two touchdown passes there for Jared Goff. From there, let's head to the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado. Check in on the Broncos. And you can see they have the lead over the visiting Tennessee Titans. Deshaun Hamilton, a touchdown reception. Lastly, let's get to the Windy City, see what's happening with the Bears at home at Soldier Field. And they were losers in that one as they fall to the visiting Seattle Seahawks. Russell Wilson, two touchdown passes as his guys remain unbeaten. In the game you're watching, it was Jimmy Garoppolo who was brilliant in that first half. He's thrown for close to 200 yards already, and that's helped propel his guys into the lead. As we send you back to Brandon Godden.
Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They go play action here on first down. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman.
When we talk about the best corners in the league, we're usually saying shutdown corners, guys you can't complete passes against. Richard Sherman fits that definition to a T. The best part of his game, no wasted moves. He studies the opponent so well, hard to get a pass on Richard Sherman.
Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the
last time.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long 21, pass. 21. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Garoppolo. Deep ball for Goodwin. And is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
Ready. Blue ready.
One with Darquan. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And the tackle there by Quan Alexander.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Now with Darquan. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run.
Let's go now.
Winston now to throw on first down. He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looks pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Ready. Watch what to do.
And they'll run it here. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And they'll go on the ground. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The Bucs on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Here's Winston. Over the middle to Evans. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A familiar ring to that one. Winston to Evans for the Buccaneer first. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him. Even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Now a play fake here on first down. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 47 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And Evans calls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Evans, his first touchdown of the new season, and the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And in the red zone, I guess this is why you have a guy like that on your roster.
Without a doubt, if you have him, you use him, because he's a guy who's going to win just about every time. I don't care what the coverage is.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that will tie us at 24. So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes Jimmy Garoppolo now to lead his offense back out there. And it was his interception on the last drive that wound up leading to a game-tying touchdown.
And somehow, you can make this a positive, though. You know why? Game-tied now. So you're not protecting a lead. So you're not playing that way. You got to go get the lead again. So maybe it loosens him up a little bit and allows him to go ahead and be a little more free in his play.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Jason Pierre-Paul. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of nine.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Now Garoppolo throwing on second. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Shaquille Barrett in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
So the sack of Garoppolo, and now what can they come up with on third and long? No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. And they're going to sack him again. The fifth time they've gotten him today, and this one results in a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
And this will be taken at the 13. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their 35-yard line.
Ready, blue ready. Boys, not up.
Boys, not up. Now they try the right side here. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz.
Back now in Tampa. It's been a good one so far. Just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. Second down, Winston. And Blake, the tight end's got it. So he got three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. That catch good for five. It's third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Complete. He finds Brain. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. The Buccaneer first, Winston to Brain.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker.
Ready.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
A dump underneath to Jones. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another 13 yards there twice in a row, and they're on the move. Another first down as well. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it, and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
To throw, Winston. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Winston in the offense with a first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Mike Evans with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. This one taken from the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
Throwing now is Garoppolo. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe you can expect more passes like that downfield.
11-11. Six.
Garoppolo to try again on second down. He's going to wind up and air it out. He's got a man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
White. 12. Six.
Garoppolo on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. To the air on second. It's Garoppolo. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they move this all the way down to the 9. He got 29 yards that time. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
13.
Garoppolo again. Drops it off for Coleman. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
To throw is Garoppolo. And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
So the sack of Garoppolo. And now what can they come up with on third and long? Garoppolo to throw. And the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. On after the sack, he's still down on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. He connected on his first, this from 41. And Gold is able to put it through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So we're back to a one-score game, and now you figure we'll likely see an onside kick.
Yeah, they've only got the one timeout remaining, so I think they've got to take a chance at getting the ball back.
Time definitely of the essence now, just under a minute to play, and here we go. And this is going to be recovered by the hand team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Victory formation now for the Buccaneers. Down to a knee they go. And on the ground they go with the running back. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. And a timeout coming in. This will be their final one with 10 seconds remaining. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down.
Ready.
Winston will kneel down, and that should be your ball game. Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Or are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Got your notes laminated, because, you know, open air boot, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond.